People living with chronic pain are fearful they're in for more suffering. Changes to the Medicare Benefits Schedule means access to life-changing nerve treatment is now restricted, leaving patients either thousands of dollars out of pocket or turning to other, more dangerous alternatives.
Vanessa Langfeldt doesn't know a life without pain. Even walking around her small garden is a struggle.
That's why you leave me stranded up the street, 10,000 paces ahead of me.
The mother of two was born with bilateral hip dislocation. Complications with her condition mean everyday tasks are excruciating.
I have very little sleep at night time. I can only sleep in one position. I need help in and out of bed. I need help with showering.
2.5 years ago, she found relief through a treatment called radiofrequency nerve ablation. The procedure uses heat generated by radio waves to target specific nerves and temporarily turn off their ability to send pain signals. Vanessa used to have the treatment every 3 months before changes to the Medicare benefits schedule capped the number of sessions that are covered.
I want our government to change this. They have made a decision that was profoundly wrong, and I will not accept that this won't change.
Vanessa has had to resort to ice packs and a TENS machine to try and ease her suffering.
And it helps mask the pain.
Or pay for each additional treatment herself, which would likely cost thousands of dollars, which the disability pensioner can't afford.
Not only do patients face the prospect of being out of pocket, doctors warn the Medicare restrictions could push them from the private sector to an already burdened public system.
Unfortunately, patients in persistent pain are already the most marginalised members of society, and it can also mean that there's long wait lists up to a year prior to being able to see a pain specialist.
We have rights as citizens to lead quality of life and have effective treatment options to us. You know, I feel that is called equality.
Samantha Butler for 10 News First.